what she's planned for supper.
He reads the Times and rails against the news of the day.
And she talks of Home Improvement
and what's playing at the movies.
And the more they talk, the more they hear the things they never say. She doesn't say,
"Why don't you love me like you used to?"
He doesn't ask,
"Why can't you be the one I need?"
They stay away from talk of emptiness and longing. Long ago, it seems they tacitly agreed to a code of silence.
She sits there with her herbal tea.
He sips his cup of Java.
And they talk of friends
and fashion trends.
A Mad Men episode.
And they steer through conversations like soldiers in a minefield.
Knowing one false turn or one true word, the whole thing might explode. He doesn't say,
"When did you turn into my jailer?"
She doesn't ask,
"When did you turn into a ghost?"
We all must pay for our security and comfort, but they wonder if the thing that costs the most is their code of silence.
Her golfing girlfriends,
and he's got his depressions, and there's always lots to talk about, there's always something new, and she bottles up her anger,
and he swallows his confessions,
and again the evening passes, and again they've made it through. She hasn't said,
"Why?"
Hasn't asked,
"Why is this life a heavy load?"
Turn down the bed for one more night of separate dreaming, knowing well they won't discuss it down the road. For they may break their hearts, but they'll never break their code of...
Goodbye, Dan.